Hello everyone, Stefano from BlueCast here. In this second video tutorial, we'll see how to properly prepare a tree for investment casting, working with castable resins. For my personal procedure, you only need a few tools. A pair of files, a cutter, some precision scissors, a wax heater or soldering iron, some wax sticks, and not much else. Of course, a lens or a loupe can also be useful for checking the quality of the printed models and the wax welds too. In this video, we will use different types of models. Some will not have a sprue, others will have a partial solution, and some will have all injection channels printed directly in 3D. Let's begin by selecting the pieces we need. We'll check their quality with our loupe, and then choose different types of patterns. This lets us evaluate different cases all at once. Now I will select all the models I want to mount on the tree. I'd like to take a moment to discuss something. To detach the printed pieces from the build platform, all you need is a cutter. Simply slide the blade under the models and they will detach easily from the platform. Because I'll have to handle the printed models longer than usual for this tutorial, I'm going to wear protective gloves. I just want to avoid damaging or dirtying the models with my hands. Having perfectly clean prints is the first secret to getting a good casting. Now, I'll start removing the print supports from the models. Since this is a castable resin, good support is crucial. Good support is closely correlated with print quality. For this reason, I strongly recommend using a sphere as the contact point. This will make it easier to remove the supports even by hand without damaging the models. It's clear that for more fragile models like this spider, the use of precision scissors and modeling pliers is mandatory. The support style we use and recommend is included in the folder where you can also find the print profiles. To save time, I prefer to perform all the work steps in series. I am now removing all the supports from the 3D prints. Although our castable resins have a high wax content and are therefore easy to weld with wax sticks, I now want to explain a step that is fundamental for me. I often see various casting errors on social media due to investment inclusions. These fragments can come from several places, but they mainly result from sloppy welds between the models and the wax rods. Consequently, I am sanding the models with a coarse grit exactly at the point where I want to weld the wax rod. I'll let you know right now that over that point, we'll melt a small amount of wax to ensure a perfect bond between the wax rods and our patterns. What I want to avoid are small cavities, holes, or empty areas where the investment can dangerously collect. It should be clear that I will sand and roughen all the parts of the models where I plan to install a wax channel. For models that require internal casting sprues, I will perform the same procedure in all the affected areas. For this commemorative ring, I believe an auxiliary channel is necessary for a correct metal flow. The sprues are positioned so that they don't damage the models, but most importantly so that their removal is easy once the casting is done. According to the model mass, I will select the sprue size and number. I will now proceed to sand all the models at the appropriate points. For models that are already printed with sprues, I will only sand the very end of the connectors, specifically where they will be welded to the central wax rod of the tree. To be honest, a Dremel could have been used in order to speed up everything, which is what I normally do. However, I preferred to proceed with manual and less expensive tools because many people think that a good casting is only possible with professional equipment, but that's not the case. The secret is to follow the correct procedures and always apply the same method. As I mentioned before, I will now proceed to melt a drop of wax on the areas that were previously sanded and prepared. I'll pay attention to covering the entire area with a very thin layer of material. Now repeat the same step for all the models. Castable resins require a little extra care, but in the end, the results will be amazing. the models printed with sprues, I'll only coat the point where I'm going to weld them to the tree with wax. These models will then be set aside until the final step. The ultimate step is to weld the wax rods to the models. The sprues are cut so that the model is in the middle, between the central post and the edge of the flask. I'll proceed from the smaller models using 3mm rods, then move on to the larger ones. Thanks to the preliminary steps, welding the wax rods to the castable resin models is now exactly like welding them to wax rings. I recommend smoothing the contact points and creating precise welds. I usually use a third-hand tool to hold the model steady, but it would have blocked too much of the view. It would have made the tutorial difficult to see, so I chose to use reverse tweezers instead. A piece of paper towel will help me avoid damaging the models. If the chosen wax stick is too thick in relation to the shank of the ring, you can modify and adapt it mechanically by squashing or shaping it. This precaution will help us avoid bottlenecks in the channels, burrs, or sloppy welds. Let me say this again. Good welds are the key to a quality casting. Sloppy, cold welds with holes or gaps can cause defects that can't be fixed. Printing the models with the sprues already attached is definitely my preferred choice. It saves a lot of time. For our castable resins, this doesn't cause any issues. You can even print entire casting trees. For less performing resins, I recommend using the classic method to reduce the mass of the models and the material that needs to be burned. I'll now finish preparing all the pieces for the final and most important phase of this tutorial, assembling the tree. Once I have all the models I need to cast, I'll do a simulation of how to arrange them on the trees to figure out the correct assembly sequence. Regardless of the height of the tree, if you can't create multiple cylinders with similar models, the lighter parts should be mounted at the top where the metal arrives hottest. This will allow the more fluid metal to fill even the thinnest sections. Standard rings and classic models can be mounted halfway up the sprue, and the larger ones should be placed near the metal entry cone. The area closest to the entry cone is where the metal arrives coldest. Here, it is most likely to avoid porosity caused by the mass of the models combined with the metal's excessively high temperature. At very high temperatures, the calcium sulfate in the investment can release a significant amount of gas, which makes the metal surface porous. As a general idea, the lowest models should be at least 1 centimeter away from the entry cone for larger cylinders and at least 5 millimeters for smaller flasks. This allows for better vacuum and helps to prevent the lowest models from collecting all the debris from the cone. Another general rule is to position models with engravings and concave parts so that they all face the top of the tree. This allows the investment to fill them easily and helps avoid air bubbles or fragile sections. I always make a habit of leaving at least 3 millimeters of space between each model. I usually use a third hand or the flask's rubber base to hold the tree steady. To improve visibility for this tutorial, you may have noticed that I'm using a bit of gum-like putty instead. This is possible because the bottom part of the main wax rod will be cut off later, so there's no risk of contamination. The flask we are using is 15 centimeters tall. I'll now proceed to complete the tree, mounting all the pieces from top to bottom, keeping in mind the few simple rules we just went over. The work is now practically finished, and it will only be necessary to double-check and refine all the welds that have been made. Here is the final result that we will be casting in the next few days. As you can see, the models are all at least 3 millimeters apart from each other and have a minimum distance of 5 millimeters from the edge of the flask. Of course, the images and videos of this tree being cast will be shared with all of you on our social media channels. I hope this tutorial was helpful, and we'll see you in the next video.